New research shows nearly 7 out of 10 smokers say they want to kick the habit. Some turn to vaping, but it may not be better than using tobacco products. UVA's Dr. Brandy Patterson weighs in this week's Straight Talk MD.
Hi, I'm Dr. Brandy P. You're watching Straight Talk MD. If you walk around the mall or even sit in traffic these days, you're likely to see someone using an electronic cigarette. These e-cigs, vape pens, and JUULs, as they're called, are quickly rising in popularity, especially among teens. Originally introduced as a smoking cessation aid, e-cigarettes continue to be marketed as such, despite the lack of evidence showing their efficacy. The truth is, there's very little hard data showing how these smokeless nicotine delivery systems impact the body. One thing we do know is that a key ingredient in e-cigarettes is nicotine. Nicotine is the highly addictive stimulant in tobacco that not only gets you hooked on smoking, but also makes it difficult to quit. Every time nicotine enters the body, it constricts the blood vessels, raising blood pressure and increasing your risk for coronary artery disease and a stroke. The more nicotine you take in, the more damaging it is to our bodies. This is important because there is a lot of gray area when it comes to determining just how much nicotine you're getting with each vape of an e-cigarette due to the lack of regulation on labeling for the e-cigarette components. The bottom line, the verdict is still out on e-cigarettes. If you are trying to quit smoking, ask your doctor about alternative cessation tools. Consider getting a prescription for an FDA-approved nicotrol inhaler, which looks like an e-cigarette and actually helps satisfy your nicotine craving safely without all of the extra chemicals you get with vaping. For more tips on kicking the habit, visit quitnow.net. Thank you for watching this segment of Straight Talk MD.